Hi everyone and welcome to View B of the Sew Along. So for View B, because there is a draw cord in the channel in the waist, we need a way of threading the draw cord through. So I'm going to use a buttonhole attachment on my sewing machine. You could also punch in some eyelets, which are called grommets, or you could even stitch in eyelets with your machine if you have that function. So we have two channel pieces to put our draw cords through. Take one of them and set it aside because this channel is going to be our back channel and we only need to put an opening for our draw cords on one of them. The position for the opening of our draw cords, if you fold this in half and find the center, and you'll know it's the center because we've snipped a small notch, we want to put our buttonhole opening 3 centimeters, which is just over 1 1/4 inches, I'll put that conversion, either side of the center. And of course, that can be entirely up to you exactly where you want to put it. The buttonhole needs to run perpendicular to the cord. So our buttonhole needs to run up and down like this. Our cord's going this way and our buttonhole needs to go this way. So what I've done is just put a small button into my buttonhole attachment and I'll go ahead and stitch those buttonholes in now. Now, because this is a knit fabric, it's a good idea to put some sort of reinforcing under. So I've just got a small piece of fuse and I'm just going to be placing that in the area behind, and I will just to reinforce it, and I'll trim that away later. And the reinforcing I have here is just fuse. So I'll trim away my excess fuse and we can move on. Now we're going to sew the pockets for View B. If you're sewing View C or no pockets, just jump over this step. We start off by taking our pocket pieces. Now we have a pair of pocket faces. And a pair means we've cut one out this way and one out that way, so some people call it a mirror. And the pocket face has the curve cut out of it. And then we have the pocket bag. And the pocket bag does not have the curve cut out of it. So we're going to start by working with the pocket face. Take the lower front, which is the skirt front, and you'll know it's the skirt front because you have those same scoops cut out of it. So place this right side up and then take one of those pocket pieces and place it face down so the curves match. So what we have is right sides together, and as you can see, I'm going to match the stripe. And what I'm going to do is overlock this curve here. So the overlock is at 6 mm, 1/4 inch. And when I've done this side, I'm then going to repeat that for the other side. So what we're going to do next is to take this pocket and turn it to the inside. Now, if you want to make sure that this pocket sits really flat, what we can do is stitch a line of top stitching, and this is called a pin stitch. with all the bulk on this side, and that will help fold that pocket to the inside. But if you want to skip that step because it's a knit fabric, that's fine. Just make sure you press that pocket, and when you press it, just make sure that that seam there is right on the edge, like so. So now we've pressed that, this turns into a lovely curve, and what we're now going to do is take one of our pocket bag pieces and sew the pockets together. So when we look at the pocket bag piece, it's a rectangle, but one side's got an angle with it, and the side with the angle on it has a notch part way down, which is here. So that notch shows us the side seam and the pocket placement. So what does that mean? Well, what we're going to do is hold our garment with the right side up, so here's the pocket on the right hand side, and take the pocket piece, and now we want to make sure that the right side here is the right side here. So basically everything is right side up, then that angled side with the notch there matches the notch at the bottom of the pocket. Now that notch is really there to guide us for view C, but we may as well use that for this pocket placement as well. So if you put those notches together there, then across the top you'll see another notch there, and the edge of the pocket fold sits on that notch there. So that is our pocket placement like that. Well, that's where it's going to be. So once you know you've got the pocket in the right place, what we're going to do is sew the pocket together on the inside. So what we want to do is sew this across here and this down here to sew the pocket together. But the key is making sure you have the pocket in the correct place before you start. So we only want to overlock those two internal seams. It's very easy to get that pocket around the wrong way, so make sure you put the pocket in the correct way before you sew. So what I'm going to do now, before I go any further and do the other side, is to just pin or clip that pocket into place. So we want to make sure it all sits nice and flat at the top, and the edge of that pocket is on the notch. Just pop a pin in there. Now if you are using pins, make sure they're the ball head pins so you don't put holes in your fabric. And I'm just going to match that down the side seam too. That'll just help us when we're sewing this together later on. And when you pin, it's always a good idea to pin within that seam allowance, which is 6mm, 1/4 inch. So that's what we've got going on now. And we're going to just repeat that on the other side. So let's do the side seam splits. Come to the lower edge and you'll see that it curves out somewhat and goes down. Now if you're sewing the straight version, this will go straight across. What we're going to do is we're going to start overlocking from around about 2 inches, maybe a bit more, 5 or 6 centimeters above this curve, all the way to the bottom. And we're going to do that on both sides. We'll be right back. And then do the same thing with the lower back piece. So let's sew the skirt together at the side seams. So place your back and your front skirt right sides together. So the easiest way to do this is to place the back right side up with the top at the top and place the front right side down. And match those side seams. So you'll have notches to match as you go. So just match those pieces together. What you'll see is down the edge where the split starts, our overlocking is going to start joining together. What we want to do is overlock the side seam, and we only want to go as far as where the overlocking joins. So overlock down, and then once it joins, come off. Now that needs to be about 2 inches, 5 centimeters above this curve here. Well, it needs to be about that measurement from our drill hole position here. Now where you get to the notch, which is where the pocket joins in, just make sure all those layers are caught. So you're going to be sewing through 4 layers. So here is where my overlocking joins, and I'm just going to go over the top of it and then just angle off the side. So when you've done that, do the same thing on the other side. So come to your sewing machine here, and what we want to do is locate the drill hole here on the split. And you want to make sure that those drill holes are sitting exactly on top of each other. So what we're going to do now is just reinforce and finish the top of the split. From the area here that you went out on, just come slightly above it. What we want to do is we want to stitch right on the edge of the overlocking and do a small back tack. From that position there, we want to stitch in a straight line directly towards the drill hole. So we're going to go from a 6mm quarter of an inch seam allowance down to a 2cm 3/4 inch. When we reach the drill hole, what we want to do is just sew just very slightly to the left of it, only just slightly, and then continue down another centimetre, which is 3/8 inch. Yeah. Now we need to tidy up the tail of the overlocker. You can do that however you like. I'm going to trim mine back to around about an inch, 2.5 centimeters, and I'm going to stitch that on top of the existing overlocking in the seam allowance. And you can see what I'm doing because I'm using a contrasting thread, like so. And then just repeat that on the other side. So now's the time, because it's nice and easy and we're here, to sew in the hem. We're going to top stitch the edges of the split as well. Now, just to make my hem a little bit tidier, and you don't have to do it. So what I'm going to do is turn the lower edge back on itself so it's right sides together. And I just want to make sure that I get this really nice curve at my hemline. So I'm going to just use my plane machine at 1 centimeter and just help that curve along. By that, you'll see what I mean. So I'm just stitching at 1 centimeter. I'm just helping that curve at the top there. You don't have to do that, but what happens if you don't do something like that, what's going to happen when you do your hem is you're going to sort of get a curve and then a straight line. So if you don't mind that look, that's fine, but it just gives a really nice finish on the inside if you do that, like so. So I'll just show you again. So what I've done is I'm folding right sides together, flip it around, so that the point of that is right on the edge of the fold, like so, and I'm going to stitch at 1 centimeter, 3/8 of an inch, up towards that split fold. But I'm just going to just curve it in ever so slightly, just to create a nice curve before I back tack off, and that will just really help the edge when it's all pressed into place, and it's going to look a little bit tidier on the inside as well. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for all four of them. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to press my hem by 1 centimeter, 3/8 of an inch, and then cover stitch that into place, or you could use a twin needle. So I've pressed up my hem allowance here. What I'm going to do is complete the edge of the split on my plane machine, just because it is a little bit challenging to do it with a twin needle when you're turning the corner at the top, but you certainly can if you want. So I'm going to, and I'm going to do it from the right side, but you could do it from the wrong side. I'm going to stitch a line of stitching directly through this overlocking, starting at the hem. Oh, as you can tell, I've pressed this to its allowance, which is 2 centimeters, 3/4 of an inch. And when I get to the top of the split, I'm just going to go around about a centimetre, 3/8 of an inch past. You can do it directly on top if you want, whatever you want to do. And I'm going to just lift my presser foot, turn and pivot, and stitch back to the same position on the other side. And then I'm going to do the same and go all the way to the hemline on the other side of the split. Now if you'd like to sew a second line of stitching, go ahead and do that. For this one I don't think I will. And when you've done that, go ahead and repeat that on the other side. When you go to stitch your hem in, just make sure you test stitch on a couple of layers of fabric spare before you begin. I'm going to use my middle and my right needles on this model for a narrow cover stitch, and just the two. And it's up to you where you want to start. You could start right from the edge here if you want. I think I'm just going to start where the stitching joins. What I might do is just start a couple of stitches before, just in case I have any problems. And I'm sure you will know where your settings are for your widths. So just make sure when you stitch that, you do it nice and smoothly. So just go ahead and repeat that on the other side. So now let's sew the upper part of the garment together, starting at the shoulders. Take your front and your back and place them right sides together, and we're going to overlock the shoulder seams. Now I'm sewing from the cuff edge, which is the arm, all the way through to the neckline. Now I'm going to sew the other shoulder together the opposite way. Now we're going to sew the side seam, so from the underarm through to the waistband. You'll see a small notch here as you approach the end. Make sure that's still visible after your overlocking is completed. You should be able to see it there. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side, the underarm seam. So now let's complete the bands on the arms. They're like a false cuff for a feature. So you can do them in contrast fabric, or because mine's a stripe, I'm doing them. like that. So place your cuffs right sides together. And we're going to overlock the shorter edge, and this shorter edge is going to become the underarm. And do the same thing for the other piece. Now, directly opposite this on the fold, you should have a notch at the top and the bottom, and that's going to help us with placing this in the correct position. So take these and fold them wrong sides together so we have right side out. And match the seams together and match the notches together. You might benefit from giving that a press. Take that cuff, come to your garment, and what we want to do, so here is the shoulder and here is the side seam. Place this cuff inside so we have right sides together, and we want to match the three seams together at the underarm. And I'm going to hold those in place with a pin. And then match that notch to the shoulder seam. When we overlock this together, just make sure that shoulder seam sits towards the back. So I'm going to start overlocking that in from one side of the underarm, and you'll find it easier to do with the band on top. Make sure when you come to this underarm seam that those seams are facing in opposite directions. It just helps the bulk go through the overlocker better. Okay, so go ahead and repeat that on the other side. For the neck band, take the neck band and place it right sides together and then overlock the short ends. Fold again so we have wrong sides together, and the seam is going to become the center back neck. Now, as we look through this, there's a notch close to that seam, so that notch will match to the shoulder seam. Then there's a notch directly opposite that seam, and that will be our center front. So take this band and place it into your garment and match those points. Going to find this easy to sew with the band on top. So that seam on the neck band matches directly to the center of the double notches on the back. Right, so when you've matched those points, overlock that into place. You'll need to gently stretch it to fit. And I'm going to start by overlocking just to one side of a shoulder seam. So now we're going to come back to our channel pieces. If you remember, one of them we put buttonholes into. So take them and go to your iron and press a 1 centimeter, which is 3/8 of an inch hem on each side. So we have this, and then place them right sides together and overlock the short ends so we have a loop. And do the same thing at the other end. Now we're going to put this garment together. Take the top and place it so that the waist area is at the upper side, and make sure the front is at the front. Then take this band that you created, the channel, and I'm going to snip those open now, just so I might not have a problem later. Just snip those open. And place this band right side together to the waist, making sure the side with the buttonholes in it is at the front, so we have right sides together. So match the notch in the center here and match the seams at the side seams. We're going to be repinning these in a minute, so this is just a temporary hold, and then there's a double notch to show us the back, and that will match a notch in the center here. And the other side seam. Take the skirt part and make sure it is wrong sides out, so right sides inside. And now place this to the band, and we want to make sure that the skirt's on the outside. So what we're going to do is take the top and put it in like that. And then match everything together again. So we want here where our buttonholes are on our band, which is the center front, to match to the notch between the two pockets. So repin that. And then come around, match those side seams. doing a bit of rearranging there, and then make sure the double notches match the double notches at the back as well. So what's going to happen, apart from the fact we're going to overlock that together, is this is the front here. So you need to make sure when this is lifted up that we have the front, the upper front and the lower front right side up, and then the band is going to come up like this and be stitched down afterwards. So the order we want everything is skirt right side down, and I'll talk about this from the front. So the front skirt, skirt right side down, wrong side up. The band should be wrong side up, and the top should be right side up. So when you have those layers in place, we're going to overlock them together. I'm going to start at a side seam. And the main thing we have to think about is making sure we catch that pocket as we go across. Now this can be a little bit fiddly, but it's not hard and there's no stretching involved. Just a matter of matching all those points, and most especially probably making sure that side seam matches. So we want all the layers. So what I find the easiest to do is just to just start with a couple of stitches, and that just sort of anchors everything in its place just to help you. It works like another pair of hands. So smooth everything down, make sure all the raw edges are even, and overlock that together. Don't forget to take the pins out as you go. Apologise for the noise in my workroom. I'm on a main road to the airport, which is also on the arterial road to the port. So as you can imagine, there's always a lot of trucks going past. So here we are, this is what the band should look like. I should have mentioned it's really easy to stitch this band on flipped, so even though the buttonholes are at the front, it's backwards. By that I mean it'll look like it needs to be stitched to the lower part of the garment. You need to make sure that when it's sewn that this band is going to come up and be stitched to the upper part of the garment. Now I did tell you to press both sides of that channel. We actually only need to press one, but it's really easy to get the wrong one. We'll just re-press that out later. Okay. So bring your garment back to your plain sewing machine, and it's really important now that you double check you have a ball needle in here, because this will definitely be an issue if it hasn't been before now. So we want to put our garment underneath here. It's a little bit awkward getting it started. Put it under here, and we are going to stitch down our channel, which is the reason why we pressed our hem in before we started. So what we're going to do is stitch this channel to the upper part of the garment. This is the lower part of the garment here. So I'm going to start at the side seam, and I'm going to stitch this in place, and I'm going to just sew it just a small amount in from the edge, so an edge stitch. It's about an eighth, it's probably half of an eighth, 1/16 of an inch in from the edge. That happened. Let's re-thread that. Okay, so we'll try that again. So just like anything when you're edge stitching, you just want it nice and straight and consistent through the whole time of stitching. That's better. Now we're going to work on the draw cords that are going to go through the channel we just created. So take one of the draw cords, fold it right sides together lengthwise, and overlock that raw edge together. Now I have a video on how to create draw cords easily. If you need help, just go to that video on my YouTube channel. And repeat for the other draw cord. Now, if you don't want to create draw cords, of course you could use cording, or you could go to somewhere like the dollar shop and buy shoelaces. That's also quite a good way of creating, quite a modern look for this drawstring. So what we want to do now is cut your length of elastic to the cut measurements on the chart. Don't make your elastic any wider than 1 centimeter. 3/8 of an inch. You'll just have a few issues with it if you do. It can be narrower. Mine is around about 8 mils. I'll put the conversion there. So what I'm going to do is just overlap this by about 1.5 centimeters, and 1.5 centimeters is 9/16 of an inch, and I'm just going to reinforce that and stitch the elastic to my cord. Now, I didn't mention, but I have the seam of my cording on this side. So when I come to the other side, I'm just going to make sure the seam on the cording is on that side too. Look, it's really not that important, but sometimes you just like all these things to be the same. I'm just going to overlap that. doesn't matter really if you're a bit more or a bit less. The main thing is you secure this down. So now we need to feed this drawcord through the waistband of our garment. Choose a nice strong safety pin and thread that through. So what we want to do is come to one side, thread that pin through our channel, and just keep feeding it through until it comes out on the other side. So once you've fed that through, what you want to do is adjust this so the ties are coming through the same length. I'll do that in a moment. Right, to tidy up the ends, what I like to do is just create a small knot, and that will hide the, you can buy end caps, it just hides that stitching at the end, it's entirely up to you. So I'm just going to do a very small knot like so, and just pull that knot through to the end. So the elastic is in there for comfort. Just makes it a little bit easier to put on and off than just a plain drawcord. So knot each of the ends. Some people like to pull that knot all the way through to the end. It's entirely up to you. And you need to go through your garment and just do a little bit of quality control work, which just means snipping the threads and giving it a press, and you're finished. Thank you very much for joining me. Thanks for buying my patterns. Really appreciate you supporting a small business. Don't forget to join my Facebook pattern discussion group. And if you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button. See you again soon.